With the release of Star Citizen's Alpha 323 a few weeks back, as with any update, we've seen performance increases in some areas, and of course, decreases in others. I've seen some people, including myself, noticing worse performance after the most recent update. Now, of course, Star Citizen is notorious for its poor optimization due to it being in an alpha state. However, there are many things that players can do to improve performance in the game, regardless of how your game runs after the update. Today, I will be showcasing some of the best tips that I have seen and that I think are worth giving a shot if you are noticing poor performance in Star Citizen. So, let's jump right into it. First, it is of course extremely important to make sure you download the latest graphics drivers for your system. So, if you have an NVIDIA graphics card, you can visit their website to enter the graphics card model you are using and get the latest drivers. Or you can download those drivers using the NVIDIA app if you have updated to that. I'll leave links to both of those in the description below. The same process goes for AMD graphics card users, and I will leave a link for those as well. Next, make sure your Windows is up to date, whether you are using Windows 10 or Windows 11. I know this might be an obvious tip, but many times there are updates that aren't automatically installed that you may need to go in and do manually. So make sure to apply any updates that are needed, and restart your PC when you are done to make sure those updates are fully applied. While we're in the Windows settings, I'd recommend going back to the home section of the settings and going to the Gaming tab. If you use Game Bar, keep this on as you'll be needing it. However, if you're not using it, I'd recommend turning this off as it takes up your PC's resources. Next, go to the Game Mode tab. For me personally, I keep this on. I've tested Star Citizen along with many other games that I play, and Game Mode tends to make the games that I play run smoother. Test the setting out for yourself, and if you notice improvements in your performance, I'd turn it on. Next, go to the Windows search bar and type Graphics Settings. Once you've gotten in here, if you have the option, I would turn on Hardware Accelerated GPU Scheduling. This, for me, brought a pretty significant performance increase to Star Citizen, as well as many other games. As always, make sure to test it for yourself, but I would recommend turning this on. Variable Refresh Rate is another setting I would recommend testing for yourself as well, but I have turned this off. Now, for graphics performance preference, go to the drop-down and select Desktop App, and then click Browse. Go to your Star Citizen game folder, which you can find in the RSI Launcher under the Settings tab, and then scrolling down to the Library folder. Click Star Citizen, then Live, bin64, then StarCitizen.exe. Select the game, and then click Add. Click the application and select Options, and then select the graphics preference to High Performance. Another thing you should do regardless of what game you are playing is make sure you have your PC's power settings set up properly. Go to the Windows search bar and type Power Plan and click Edit Power Plan. Go back to Power Options, and if you already see it, select Ultimate Performance. If you do not see it, you can easily add it by doing a quick command prompt command. Go back to the Windows search bar, type CMD, and then right click command prompt and run as administrator. Copy and paste the line I have put in the description and press Enter, and it should be activated on your computer. If you still don't see the option in the settings, restart your PC and it should be there once you come back. The next tip I have is to set the CPU priority of the game to high. You are unable to change the priority of Star Citizen with the basic task manager, however, you can do it with a program similar to something like Process Lasso, for example. If you would like to use Process Lasso, I will leave a link to the download page in the description below. Once you've downloaded it, you can open Process Lasso as well as Star Citizen. Once your game is launched, look for StarCitizen.exe in either the All Processes tab or the Active Processes tab. I also like to apply the same settings to the StarCitizen_Launcher.exe application as well, just for good measure. Right-click on StarCitizen.exe, look for CPU Priority, and then Always. Select High, and then it should be set to High Priority whenever you launch the game. While you're here, if you'd like, you can test playing the game with Intel's hyperthreading or AMD's SMT, or simultaneous multi-threading, disabled or enabled. For me, I found that disabling SMT on my system gave me a slight boost in performance, and if you'd like to do this, right-click on StarCitizen.exe, look for CPU Affinity, Always, and then select Disable SMT or hyperthreading for Intel users. Like I said, test this for yourself to see what works best for your system, but I have heard from many players that this improves performance for them as well. If you would not like to use Process Lasso, you can still change the CPU priority of the game by using the Registry editor. If you have the game, close it just to be safe. Then press the Windows icon and type Registry editor. Open it and follow the path on the screen, or just follow along with me. Once you've gotten to the Image File Execution Options folder, right-click on the folder, go to New, and then click Key. Make sure to name it StarCitizen.exe and make sure the capitalization and spelling of each word matches the program name. It should look something like this. Make another key in the StarCitizen.exe folder called Perf Options, like you see on the screen. Right-click the folder and select New, then DWORD 32-bit value. Name it CPU Priority Class and match the spelling with what I have on the screen. Double-click CPU Priority Class and select Hexadecimal, and then type in the box the value 3. Then press OK, and you should be good to go. If you notice instability with the game, use 6 as your value, as this will set the game in an above normal priority state. And if that still doesn't fix instability, delete the folders you've made or set the value to 2. Next, if you are using an NVIDIA graphics card, there are many settings that are important to make sure you're using in the NVIDIA control panel. Open the NVIDIA control panel by going to your desktop, right-clicking, and selecting NVIDIA control panel. Once you are here, go to the Manage 3D Settings tab, and under Global Settings, feel free to copy any settings you might see that I have. But the most important setting to change is shader cache size. I'd recommend setting this to 10 GB and 100 if you feel the need to. Next, go into the Program Settings tab, and under the dropdown, look for Squadron42-Star Citizen. If you don't find it in the dropdown, that's okay. Just click the Add button, click Browse, and go to the same folder we went to before and select starcitizen.exe. Most of these settings you can leave as the global setting unless you feel the need to change them. However, I like to change low latency mode to on, power management mode to prefer maximum performance, texture filtering anisotropic sample optimization to on, texture filtering quality to high performance, trilinear optimization to on, triple buffering to on, and vertical sync to fast. These settings work very well for me and my system, and after testing the other options, I found these settings to work the best. As always, make sure to test them for yourselves though, as not everyone's system is the same. Another big thing you can try is enabling Resizable Bar on your PC if you haven't already. A good way to check if you have this enabled is by going into the NVIDIA control panel, and in the Help tab at the top of the screen, click System Information. Look for the section that says Resizable Bar, and if it is enabled, it will say yes. I've found that with Resizable Bar enabled, I was getting way better or at least way more consistent performance. This is something I would highly recommend trying as it essentially unlocks the full potential of your GPU. I'll leave a link in the description to a tutorial on how to enable Resizable Bar for anyone who is interested in doing so. Also, I'd recommend disabling the High Precision Event Timer in the Device Manager, as this can sometimes decrease performance. If you are someone who codes on your system, I wouldn't recommend turning this off, but you can test this for yourself to see if it helps performance on your system. To do this, go to the Windows search and type Device Manager. Then go to the System Devices tab and look for the High Precision Event Timer. Right click and disable. A few quick tips I'd also recommend is closing any background apps when you're playing the game. Sometimes when you close applications like Google Chrome, they don't really close, so you may have to go to the Task Manager to shut them down. I'd also recommend using the Task Manager to see any applications that are running that are eating up your resources, that way you can shut them down if you don't need them. Right-click the taskbar and click Task Manager. Once you're here, click More Details if you haven't already, and scroll through the list in whatever category you are struggling in and close apps you don't need by clicking them and then clicking End Task. Another thing you can do is go to the bottom right where the hidden icons are located and close any unneeded apps there. Another thing you should do after almost any update to Star Citizen is to delete your shader folder. To do this, simply press the Windows button and the R key at the same time and type %localappdata%/StarCitizen. Once you're here, you should see a folder named something along the lines of sc-alpha-3.23.1_ and then a bunch of random letters and values. Open this folder and right-click the shaders folder, hold down the shift key, and then click delete. The next time you open the game, you may notice a slight bit of lag, but as the shaders load in, you may see a higher FPS than you did before. Once you've done all these things, restart your PC, and then we can jump into Star Citizen to actually change the in-game graphics settings. Once you're in Star Citizen, click the Options button in the bottom left of the screen, and then select the Graphics tab. For Gamma, I have this set to 45, Brightness to 50, Contrast to 55. This is personal preference, but I find this to give the game the best look in terms of vibrance and visibility. Resolution should be set to your monitor's native resolution, and for Window mode, I use full screen because borderless and windowed can sometimes cause performance decreases in some instances. Graphics Render has Vulkan added as a new option. Vulkan is great, however, this is a very early look at the Vulkan renderer in Star Citizen, so I'd suggest sticking with Direct 3D 11 as Vulkan has some issues in its early state. But like I've said, feel free to test both and see which works best for you and your system. UI aspect modifier has no impact on performance, so set this to whatever you would like. Upscaling and upscaling technique is another setting that should be tested on your own personal system. However, I found that my RTX 3070 Ti using DLSS at balanced or quality has worked great for me. But to test this, go to somewhere like Art Court Plaza and test each of the upscaling methods and their settings to see which looks the best and gives the best performance. HDR should be set to off. I have an HDR monitor, but I don't use HDR, so I have it disabled in the Windows settings, so it's not available for me. Now for the important ones. It's been said by many people that Star Citizen is a very CPU intensive game, and the thought is that the lower you set your quality settings to, the more strain it will put on your CPU rather than your GPU. As with any setting, test them on your system, but I've used these settings on both my current system and older part system, and performance is better on both. For quality, I have this set to high, scattered object distance is set to high, water simulated regions I would set to either off or very high, terrain tessellation distance is set to high, screen space shadows is set to high, and the most performance costly setting, planet volumetric clouds, is set to off. Field of view can cause slight performance issues, but I set mine to 110 because some ships like the Aegis Avenger Titan have HUD issues when flying at max FOV. Motion blur should be set to off as it drains resources. V-sync is personal preference, but I would set it to off. Sharpening is set to 100. Chromatic aberration is set to 0, and film grain and session QR code are both set to no. Once you've applied all these settings, feel free to enter the persistent universe to test out these settings and see which ones work best on your system. This can take a lot of time and trial and error, but to maximize performance, it is definitely needed and worth doing. So that is my Star Citizen optimization guide for 323. I hope these tips helped you out, and if there are any suggestions or tips that I may have missed that work well for you, feel free to leave those in the comment section down below for others, including myself, to use to get the maximum performance in Star Citizen. I hope you all enjoy your time in the persistent universe, and as always, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any future uploads, and I will see you guys in the next video.